I'm thinking this is going to be great for the beach area. It's great to see something opening and coming back.
Boy, I kind of wish I was there right
now,
don't you?
Nice.
The day is finally here. Margaritaville Resort on Fort Myers Beach is opening its doors, and we are giving you a look at the island's first major resort to open on Estero Island in decades.
Yeah, pretty exciting stuff. We have been talking about it forever. From over 250 guest rooms to the sprawling Sunset Terrace, there is sure to be something for everyone to enjoy. And we have NBC2's Gage Golding live at the resort off Estero Boulevard. Gage, I know this place wasn't cheap to build. How's it look?
How'd you get that assignment, Gage?
I don't know. I had to pull some strings, I guess. Maybe I was slipping somebody some drinks on the assignment desk, because this place is amazing. It's 5 o'clock somewhere, a little after 5 o'clock right now, but there's no better place to be than right here at Margaritaville. The 254-room hotel cost $200 million and took 9 years to plan and build. And where we're at right now, this is called the Sunset Terrace. But enough of this, ugly mug. Turn around, Siobhan. Show them what they want to see. This is the view from the Sunset Terrace. Do you want to guess how they got the name? It's because of the amazing sunset that you'll see right here. And this is the fun hub of the resort. We have bars, we have restaurants, and places for the entire family. It's truly the center of the resort, but it is far from all that there is to offer here.
It's surreal.
That's probably the best way to describe cutting the ribbon.
1, 2, 3. Yeah!
And on the first resort to open on Fort Myers Beach in 2 decades.
It is a light of hope.
For co-CEO Tom Torgerson, it's a passion project. Before, and even more so after Hurricane Ian.
Now with us opening, the momentum is really picking up.
Starting this afternoon, several bars, restaurants, and retail spots are open, not to mention the St. Somewhere Spa.
To have activity and people back down here is just amazing.
All of this is built around the massive Sunset Terrace. This area takes up about an acre of space.
When you check in and you walk across from the front desk, this is what you're going to see.
And I'm sure after exploring everything that Margaritaville has to offer, you're probably wondering, okay, where am I spending the night? This is just one example of the very many suites that you could have right here on Fort Myers Beach.
Well, I'm thankful that we can stay overnight. At least we got this one night.
Tonight, around 100 people will break in the guest rooms for the resort's soft opening. But come Monday, nearly all of the 254 rooms here will be open, with the exception of rooms on the Gulf side of Estero Boulevard.
I'm thinking this is going to be great for the beach area.
Now look, there's still some work to do. The Fins Up Beach Club and the island's largest swimming pool won't be open until late January. However, all of this wouldn't be possible without that one guy who sang that one song. You know how it goes.
Wasting away again in Margaritaville.
The father of the Margaritaville brand, Jimmy Buffett, passing away in September.
I know he wanted to be here. I know he would have been here.
The Margaritaville brand is massive, but CEO Tom Torgerson says this resort is something special. This is not a massive high-rise. It's part of the community in laid back, just like Jimmy Buffett. Now, speaking of community, it takes quite literally a village to keep this place up and running, keep those drinks flowing, those pina coladas, those margaritas, everything that keeps people happy and enjoying time out here. It takes a lot of people. Coming up at 6 o'clock, we're going to show you how many people it takes to run this place, plus how it means a little bit more, especially after this island went through something like Hurricane Ian. I'm reporting live and local at Margaritaville on Fort Myers Beach. Gage Golding, NBC2.